Mom, come over here. Check this out.
What are you doing?
This is 5G edge computing. We're bringing 5G closer to the edge. Isn't that awesome?
I don't think this is how it works.
In today's Up to Speed, we are indeed living on the edge. Verizon's 5G edge, of course, and it's got our most innovative customers ready to change the world with us. You've seen Hans on stage with our friends at Amazon Web Services, and the collaboration continues. This week, we've added three new mobile edge computing cities, Atlanta, New York, and Washington, D.C. These new mech cities are where developers and businesses can build and deploy applications with AWS Wavelength at Verizon's 5G edge. Add in our Boston and Bay Area mech city launches from last month and plans to add five more cities by the end of the year, and there is no doubt our team is paving the way for industry transformations.
What we are creating is we're creating the ingredients for a recipe to be created by the broader developer community. They are the innovators. We are looking for them to drive the innovation.
We are trying to make sure that it's right from the day one and it's also scalable. So whether it's processes, the infrastructure, and the people behind it, we are making sure everything is coming together.
Some of our business customers are already testing their edge solutions at the edge of our 5G network. Check this out. The video platform company Zixi is testing how major broadcasters can deliver live 4K content using 5G Edge. It could one day lead to super low latency live broadcasts without the need for satellites. Sports fans, get excited about YBVR's next generation VR video platform, testing how 5G and AWS Wavelength can allow simultaneous users to choose various camera views during live 8K sporting events. Then there's CrowdVision, testing how Verizon's 5G Edge can help measure crowd congestion, traffic flows, queues, and wait times in high traffic venues. A solution that may usher in a new chapter for all of us.
We see a bright future where we are deploying at venues around the country and using our data to help the venues reopen safely.
We are not done yet with this Up to Speed episode, not until we proudly share the trailer for Makers Not Done documentary, celebrating how far we've come in the women's movement and acknowledging there is more work to do. Here's that trailer.
I didn't know that I was going to be the opening speaker at the march in Washington, D.C. I don't think anybody knew what we were walking into other than the feeling that it was necessary and we had to be there.
I see this as a moment of taking feminism back, making feminism a project that all of us can share.
Black lives win!
Black lives matter!
Black lives win!
When I put the hashtag in front of Black Lives Matter, I was like, we're gonna make this thing go viral.
I still remember the exact moment when we hit the publish button.
We kind of watched with wonder as the story started to take off like wildfire.
Everybody's like, oh good, look, now we have a movement. And I'm like, nah, Me Too is a tiny part of a large movement that's been happening for decades.
I got a call saying, a bunch of us are gonna gather. Do you wanna come over and join us? I said yes, because I was mad.
This was before we even had the name Time's Up.
Someone may have slammed their hand on the table and said, time's up on all of this behavior. And then it was like, oh, that's our name.
There's a renaissance that's happening inside of Hollywood.
I remember calling my attorney and saying like, if I say this, are we sure that it's true? On behalf of women everywhere, I will brag. I am the highest paid showrunner in television.
The United States Congress certainly was not built for young women, but it's really young women of color who have pushed forward for so many changes, and that has just turned the power dynamics here on Capitol Hill on its head.
The world and this country is changing. It's been changed. And I think that we have an opportunity this time to do it right.
Say our name!
Say our name!
There are some people who think that we are post-civil rights, we are post-feminism, and therefore we're post-intersectional. I can't see how we're post-anything, and I can't see how we can possibly think we're done.
This film is the first project supported by the Future Fund, a $5 million commitment from Verizon to support new and emerging female talent across entertainment and technology. Now, before we go, we invite you to join us for a town hall event later today.
The Resilience 2020 Town Hall will be live streamed today, 3 p.m. Eastern, addressing how all of us can build confidence and stay resilient during these unpredictable times. Our own Verizon Consumer Group CEO, Ronan Dunn, will be part of a few conversations. Check it out today, 3 Eastern.
So let's all stay resilient and finish 2020 strong. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, you're up to speed.